Good evening and welcome to the Whisky Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. Tonight, another sample, and it is the Glen Scotia Double Cask. It is bottled at 46% ABV, another Campbelltown product. It is matured in ex-bourbon cask and finished in Pedro Ximénez casks. It is non-gel filtered, and with a little bit of a digging, I also found out that it does contain some colorant. Although in some bottles you will not see that, but if you go to the German market, where it's mandatory by law to put on a bottle or on the label, if they do add colorant, and of course in this one there's a little bit of color that was added, hence the dark appearance, because it is a non-age statement whiskey, so not really always possible to get a lot of color out of it. So I'm just going to give this one a quick pour, and while I give it a little bit of time in the glass, I'm going to tell you a little story where I first time I had this. And today was a really cold day in Belgium, of course. It was raining all day, of course. So not a lot of sun. And when I was thinking back, where did I first try this one? And when I realized it was a couple of years ago, and it was in the fantastic little town called Stone Town in Tanzania on the island of Zanzibar. So this is the first time that I've actually tried this one. And of course, when you're in this nice tropical settings, everything does taste a lot better, considering the scenery. And I will put a little bit of some photos on, so that you can also experience what I experienced during my holiday in Zanzibar. So as you can imagine, the first thing that every tourist does, they go to Mercury's, and where Freddie Mercury was supposed to be born. And so did a visit there, went to the restaurant on the beach next to the port. You have a nice restaurant called Mercury's. The first time I went there, it was always packed. That was many years ago, I think about 2003, 2005. It's the first time I went to Zanzibar. I've been all in all to Zanzibar maybe 5 or 6 times, maybe 10, 12, 13 weeks I've spent on the island. So I know the island quite well, explore the island from corner to corner. So Freddy's was, or Mercury's was the restaurant to be. My last two visits, not so much anymore. I think there's a lot of other fantastic restaurants. The one that comes to mind is the Silk Road. It is a Indian fusion type restaurant, fantastic cheap cocktails, and I will put some photos up of that as well. And of course you have to go to Africa House. Every night of a sunset in Africa House, they will put the chairs out on the deck, and all the tourists will come there, have a couple of beers, watch the sun go down, and then they will send the dhows across the sunset, and it is a fantastic photo opportunity, and I think millions of people have taken that opportunity to take some nice photos of the sunset and the dhows coming past. And of course you have to go to the south of the country, and for the little bit of a outing on one of the dhows, I'll put some photos up. And on a nice little sand island that you can go spend some time snorkeling, maybe do some sun tanning, very popular quite packed, very small, but it's in the middle of nowhere. And of course, when you go for your lunch at a nearby island where they serve only crayfish or lobsters and prawns and fries, and fantastic. So that's a little bit of me reminiscing. Also, and I did find a whisky shop. You'll be quite surprised. Whisky is not a big thing. But if you go to the post office in Stonetown, there's a small, just across the post office, there's a small little shop with a small little door that you can go in. They do have a nice selection of whiskies, and it's not very expensive. So have a look when you're in Stonetown. There is an opportunity to go buy some cheaper whiskies. So on the Glen Scotia, and I'm thinking with this bad weather outside, it would have been lovely to be in Zanzibar now, lying in the sun in a warm tropical heat. Anyway, back to the whiskey. So the Glen Scotia, on the nose. Cheers. The first thing that I do get, and I'm not sure if it's maybe reminds me of my trip to Zanzibar, but I get a little bit of a pawpaw note, a nice ripe pawpaw, a little bit funky pawpaw note that you get. Really nice. So it is quite sweet on the nose. And I think that comes from the Pedro Ximenez cask, which is supposed to bring quite a sweetness to it. So I do get a sweet note. Toffee, a caramel note, maybe a little bit of a combination between the two of it. And a hint of cinnamon also, quite pleasant. The alcohol, bottled at 46%, I do get the alcohol. So if you stick your nose in, give it a little bit of a agitation, you do get the alcohol notes that's quite strong on it. Also what I get is a little bit of a red apple. And I think this is something also more like a toffee apple that brings the caramels, sugar coming together, and maybe a hint of a toffee apple, a red toffee apple. Quite pleasant on the nose for me. And I also get a little bit of a chocolate note now. And it reminds me of the fudge that we make, where you put a little bit of a cocoa powder in it to make it chocolate fudge. Quite similar to that. Lovely on the nose. So on the taste, cheers. So the first thing that you get is it's sweet. And when just after the sweetness, you get a little bit of a oakiness, a little bit of a caramel note. And that's my dog snoring away. And when you get the pepper note, a little bit of maybe like a black pepper clove note. And I suspect that is because of the 46% ABV. It is quite strong. It's quite youthful on the tongue. You get that little bit of strong alcohol taste in it. So then another thing that I do pick up. So what I do pick up is the dry mouthfeel. As soon as you swirl it around in your mouth, swallow, and your mouth is bone dry immediately. Not always a bad thing, but this one is quite excessive. The more you drink, the drier your mouth gets. Now also the pawpaw note is coming out even stronger. And I think this is also a good one to as a reminder, put it in a glass for a little bit of time, especially at 46% ABV, Just give it a little bit of time in the glass so that they can get some oxygen in it. So, let me try again. It's quite balanced. It is a little bit more oaky for me than the 15-year-old, which is a little bit of a surprise. Pleasant, balanced, sweet oak. I also get a little bit of an espresso note coming out, maybe even going it a little bit further into a Turkish coffee. It is quite oaky for me. But I'm getting used to the oak. It's not that bad for me anymore. It is quite pleasant. I also get now a little bit of a burnt sugar note as well, or maybe burnt caramel. So on the finish, I do get a sweetness. It's quite medium to long finish actually. You get a sweetness when you get a little bit of oak coming in, and that oak slowly disappears and it leaves you with a sweetness again, but a quite a dry mouth as well. So not too bad. And I think when you're in the tropics drinking this the first time, I cannot remember the bitterness. So maybe the atmosphere also changes a little bit on how you taste it. And I also suspect if it's hotter weather, maybe it might influence your taste buds. So my thoughts, that's caramel now. That pawpaw now has moved into quite a lot of caramel. Very pleasant. The nose for me, it's really up there. I get all these nice flavors coming out. And but on the taste for me, it was a little bit flat. So it is like two or three things that you pick up, the sweetness, a little bit of a caramel, but that is because of the sweetness. And then the oakiness coming in, and that's more or less the notes that you get on the taste. So not complex, but it is enjoyable. And I know a lot of my friends will also enjoy this one. So score-wise, I'm looking at 72 out of 100. So thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe. Or don't like and subscribe. But as long as you subscribe. And let's talk whiskey. Cheers.